Apollo GraphOS can help you build a polished, flexible, and future-proof API without the risk of it breaking in production. And it does that while leveraging the best-in-class developer experience of GraphQL. Let me show you my 5 favorite features right now. After signing up, you can create a demo graph, which is the easiest way to explore the GraphOS platform. The first of my favorite features is GraphOS Studio Explorer. GraphOS is a platform. Studio is the main UI to that platform, and Explorer is the piece we're going to look at right now. The Explorer lets us immediately start sending operations and getting data back. We can also see where the data is coming from. If we add more fields, GraphOS automatically fetches them from the appropriate places. Let's take a quick look at how a client can use that data. This is an audio streaming app, and it's fetching playlists, artists, and tracks with a GraphQL query. The real-time playback status is coming from a GraphQL subscription. Even though these are separate microservices in the backend, to the frontend, it looks like a single GraphQL server. This is all possible because of a part of the GraphOS platform called the router. When I hit play, a GraphQL operation is sent to the router. The router breaks down the operation and intelligently calls the relevant GraphQL microservices. That's a process you may have heard of. It's called federation. With that in mind, the second thing I want to show you is the subgraphs page. We can add a new microservice with just a couple of clicks. I'm adding this Discord API so users can see when and where our podcasts are live streamed. Shameless plug for both our Discord and our podcast, which you can check them out in the links below. Okay, so we added in the Discord API and GraphOS verified that the new data fits together with the existing data and that nothing breaks in production. Third, the change log will show us how our schema evolves over time. You effectively get little diffs every time you make a change. Let's click through to favorite feature 4, the schema page. It shows us every field on any type and where those fields are coming from. You can look at it however you want, like let's just look at the new fields from our Discord subgraph. Last up, and my favoritest of all, is schema checks. GraphOS integrates with our CI pipeline to stop bad things from happening. If we delete a field that the front end relies on, our pull request is blocked from merging, and we can click into GraphOS to get more info. It tells us exactly why deleting that field is a problem. We can also catch conflicts between services and even style issues. And that's it. A bunch of fun things to check out in GraphOS, but there's a whole lot more to see. You can create a demo graph today, or follow the step-by-step tutorial in the description. Also, pop into the Apollo Discord, because we'd really love to see you.